rock, y'all. No, stop, y'all. To the beat, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock.
Well, I'm John Ross-Duggan. I am a radiologist. I'm 46, so I've got a lot of time on the water. So I pretty much know the edge of my envelope, and I pretty much know what I should go out in and what I shouldn't. I've loved to surf since I was 13. Started to compete actually when I was in college. I surfed for Irvine and went with the surf team up and down California coast. I had the whole world palm of my hand, 22 years old. Had everything going on, and that all changed. I was in a car wreck, high speed, hit a bridge. Well, I fractured my neck, crushed the spinal cord, became quadriplegic. I'm a C67 quad, which means that I've lost probably all but 30 to 40% of my arms, my dexterity, and I have nothing below 2 inches above the nipple. No sensation and no muscle. My life changed in an instant at age 22. And I'm not happy here, but you've got to play your cards or don't. When I realized I could never surf again, I was pretty down. Became basically completely dependent on people for everything. Got around in an electric wheelchair. After about a year or so, I started to swim again in the pool to stay in shape. And then, back in the 80s, I started to paddle. I'd get on a windsurfing board and I'd paddle. I wouldn't go on the surf, I'd just paddle on the shallows, in the lagoons and, you know, along beaches. And then, after about 20 years, being paralyzed, kind of really look at the surf again, and really look at my disability, and really kind of plan what I need to do to make a board to get in the water. Basically, I'd sat on the land long enough. You know, it was kind of humiliating to consider going back out there laying down, but every time I talked to people, they were supportive. And then I went and talked to shapers and some pro surfers. And, you know, these guys looked at me and I'd lay down on the blank and we'd kind of sketch out where we'd put me in final position to paddle and ride. So this is the second generation board put together since the summer. The previous board was 10 foot, this is 11.6. It's a lot longer, it's got a lot of nose on it. The board narrows where I paddle, where I bring my arm into the water. We brought the rail in so I'd have more arm in the water to keep speed up, called the banjo. This is the chest and chin pad. It supports the chest and the chin. I don't have the muscles in the back to hold my head up. Hip and knee pads, rail pads. You can see it's wider in the front where the hips go. And narrower back in the knees. And you can see the little pockets dug into the deck here for where my knees sit. X pad back is what holds the legs in place. And then the two tail pads hold the feet on the board in a pretty secure position. You know, some people look at me and they think I'm just crazy. They think I got a suicide wish, but I think that I'm paralyzed, and I think that I want to keep living. I want to keep experiencing what I did before best I can. I can't sit on the beach anymore. I've got to get in the water. Today I'm going in.
Let's do it right now. Back up, lift up one little bit. That's it. You got to roll me flat. Loaded!
I'm going to need two men. I can surf with one person in the water, but I'll need two and maybe three to launch. Launch me on the board. Getting into the water is difficult. You basically have to plan your route real well. You've got to you got to minimize the distance of crossing the sand. You can't really have too many stairs. You can't have any cliffs. And you got to have a beach break to come in. You can't be slow loading into a nasty shore break.
Loaded, ready to surf.
Yeah.
Cowabunga.
Once I get in and get situated and comfortable, they put the leash on.
Basically, I'm ready to rock, position on the board, and paddle out.
And then I paddle out right next to them, and we go out and we surf basically as a pair. I reflect the person I'm surfing with. If I'm surfing alone, I take off on the white water, and I'm really kind of, I look like a, you know, very much of a beginner. But if I'm out with an experienced surfer, you know, they make me look pretty good. We plan our attack into waves. We plan our, we pick our waves early. We turn for the beach. I accelerate. They come behind. They push me in. And I drop on the open face and basically ride the shoulder of the wave. Surfing is dangerous for anybody, and it's obviously more dangerous for me. Fortunately, I'm a floater. When I fall off the board, I float, and I've got good ability to swim. I've got relatively good knowledge of waves, so if I see a set coming, I just know to relax and go under it. What it's going to do to me is not going to hurt. I may be held underwater 5 seconds, 15 seconds. I know I'll come up. And it's just a matter of kind of relaxing into it. It doesn't really get very scary. Getting hit by a wave is a wonderful thing. I never, never thought I'd get back in the surf. So when you get hit by a wave, you know, in the old days I'd be kind of disappointed because I'd potentially get rolled off the board. It'd slow me down, but now I don't mind it at all. I like getting you know, ragdolled. I like getting tossed. It's a good feeling. Water provides life for me. It is youth to me. My wrinkles are down. My skin glows. My hair is healthy. I'm in better shape than I've been in since I broke my neck. I'll tell you, you certainly don't think about being paralyzed out there. You just think about catching waves. You don't think about any facet of your disability. Well, you know, I don't really put any boundaries on where I'm going to go to surf now. All I really need is the time which I'm making. And people to go with or know that people are there to help.
Lahaina breakwall, we're surfing with a Dr. John. We're gonna catch some waves, we're gonna pull inside. Don't you know that's what's going on?
You got it.
Drop right in, we'll paddle out, we'll catch one wave. Big Mike was there on the save. You put Doc John on a barrel ride, and he never has been the same. No, he never has been the same.
Surfing again was easy. It was just basically opening my mind to it and making the board and getting people to help me. Because in my mind, I have stored up all the tapes about how to ride waves, how to paddle out, how to duck dive, how to go under, you know, how to avoid rocks. You know, I built my stamina up to being able to surf 2-3 hour sessions now. Someone has done this before. They've been disabled and surfed. You know, I've got an opportunity now to potentially influence other people, and you know, I feel my job was done if I got just one more person out in the surf. It would change their life like it changed mine.
And the dreams that you dream of, dreams really do come true. Lemon drops high above the chimney top. That's where.